So what we're going to be doing in this series of little vignettes is help us really look harder at how we help when people may not want a little assistance getting their clothing, their outer clothing on, or another layer of clothing on because of the weather. And then we may work on getting them back off. That can also be a challenge. So typically what happens when somebody wants to help somebody put on a jacket is we start off by having them try to get their arm in. And if they can close their hand up, as Amanda just did, less of an issue. And then we have another place where we can run into trouble though, even then, where we bring it up around, and now we're asking this person to reach up near their face and to stick their arm through a hole. And whoa, hang on, don't push yet. Wait. And so what ends up happening very frequently is in the underarm area of whatever the piece of clothing you're trying to get on, you end up with ripped up seams, or the person gets upset and frustrated. So what we're gonna do is try something a little different. This is a very different use of hand under hand, but what the care partner does is slip their hand through the sleeve, bring it through, and now simply offer the person handshake, hand under hand, and then slide the sleeve on so that their hand holds on to yours as you bring it through and you don't catch fingers, but you also can slip it into place. Then what we're going to do is drop it down to the elbow because it is much easier, Amanda, lean up a little bit, there we go, to bring this around and go low because now, Amanda, what I can do is guide Amanda's hand if she has full ability to use her arm and use her hand and just help her bring it up in place. Or if she needs a little more help on this side because her fingers get stuck again, keep this down below the elbow. That's the trick because we want the person to bring their arm back just a little bit. And that movement typically is an easier movement than this movement. And it also doesn't stress the cloth. Then what I'm going to do is do the same thing I did on the other side. Bring my hand through, hand under hand, slip her arm back. She just follows my movement. Bring her hand up, and then bring the clothing up. Seems so simple, it's hard to imagine that we don't think of these things. But when we're used to putting our own clothes on, we can bring it up and over and then just do this activity. But when you're trying to help someone else, it just feels awkward and it feels like you're being forced. And we're here to support. So in the last sequence, we were dealing with a zip up the front or open in the front kind of jacket or top. Let's say we have someone who likes over top and doesn't have the opening in the front, an overhead shirt, an overhead sweater. So what we're going to do is something a little bit different, but similar. Same concepts. And what we want to think about this time is that we're going to want that shirt above the arms and the head goes through last, unlike what most folks do. What we do is we put the head in, no, it's okay, and then we try to get both arms down. Come here, Anna, hang on, wait a minute, here, let me get you, wait, here. And so what we end up doing battle where if they have binocular or monocular vision, they can't even see what's going on with the hand and the holes, and they're trying their best, and it feels like we're fighting with them. So what we're gonna do is change the sequence. And instead, much as we did before, we're gonna start off with the shirt here. I'm gonna reach up the sleeve, just as I did before, if the fingers are a problem. I'm gonna offer hand under hand, and I'm going to get in this position, bring it through, and now I'm actually going to make sure it's above the elbow on this side. Come around, I'm going to do the same thing on this side. Reach up through, get all the way through, and then hand under hand, arm in, pulling it up. The other nice part about this is if they have a long sleeve on, I can actually hold on to the cuff of the sleeve so it doesn't slide up as well, so I'm just doing the extra layer on. I've got this all the way up. Now what I'm going to do is use hand under hand. Oh, look. What happens here is she doesn't ever not see what's happening. She doesn't feel blinded by the shirt. And this is a real normal movement. And with just a little shoulder, and she spontaneously started to pull it down herself. So do I need to do as much with the hands? It all depends on the person I'm working with. But the idea is we get the shirt above the elbows, open the head up, and the head goes in.